Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. This video is a sequel of previous video where we have discussed the derivation of formulas for various torques of induction motor. And now we'll be using those formulas to solve example 7.5 or actually discuss example 7.5. Okay, these were the formulas that we had derived, and we'll be using these formulas to solve a problem given here. So I hope your teacher allows you to use a cheat sheet so you can write these formulas to solve. Or if you have difficulty, then I'll also try to make another video where you don't have to memorize all these. Okay, for now, keep a record of all these formulas. We'll be using these. Okay, let's go to the question or example 7.5. First of all, voltage is 460 volt, 25 horsepower, 60 hertz, 4 pole, Y connected. Wound rotor induction motor has the following impedances, these impedances. So what I have done is that I have drawn the equivalent circuit for induction motor. First of all, I have plugged in all the values that are given here, like R1, this is R1, this is X1, so all the values I have plugged in. I have also plugged in the voltage. Now this diagram is for single phase diagram. The voltage given always in the question in this form is line to line voltage. So 460 is line to line voltage. We have to convert that into line to phase voltage. So we have to divide that by under root 3. So the phase voltage is 266 volt. Okay. Now this given, the question has four parts. What is the maximum torque of this rotor and at what speed and slip? Similarly, what is the starting torque? Then when the rotor's resistance is doubled, then you have to calculate two parameters, and finally you have to plot the graph. Okay, so let's go to question number 1A. Okay, what is the maximum torque of this motor? At what speed and slip does this occur? So actually there are three questions. Let's see. First formula is for maximum torque. This formula we have derived already, so we'll straight away use this formula, and there is not much intelligence involved in this. You simply plug in the values. Then we have to also find the slip. This is the formula for slip, so we'll use this formula. And then we have to also find speed. So this formula is for the speed of the rotor, or the mechanical speed is 1 minus slip and sink speed, or the synchronous speed. Okay. So for solving all these three, we need to find V Thevenin. We got to have R Thevenin, X Thevenin and omega sink. So let's find these one by one. This is the formula for V Thevenin. So we'll plug in all the values from the circuit. 266 for the voltage, XM 26.3, and similarly all the other voltages plugged in, and using your scientific calculator you can straight away get the answer 255.2 volt. So V Thevenin we have found out. Formula for R Thevenin is this formula. Here also we'll just simply plug in the values. So R Thevenin is 0.590. X Thevenin is equal to X1, which is 1.106. Okay, so this is the equivalent circuit, Thevenin equivalent circuit, V Thevenin, R Thevenin, X Thevenin. We connect the disconnected portion or the load portion here. Okay, and finally we have to find omega sink. Omega sink, when we talk of omega, we are talking of the angular frequency in radians per second, and that can be achieved if you know the synchronous speed, multiplied by 2 pi radians divided by 60. So let's see what is nsync. Now nsync can be found from this formula: 120 into the frequency, line frequency, divided by number of poles. And so that is 1800 revolutions per second. Putting this value in here, we get omega sync to be 188.5 radians per second. Okay, so we found all these four terms. Now let's get the formula again for Tmax. We just plug in all the values. Tmax is 229 Newton meter. And the slip, again we plug in the values here, slip maximum is 0.198. And the third parameter, the mechanical speed, is 1 minus S and sync. We know all the values, S from here, 1800 RPM was the sync speed. So the mechanical or the rotor speed is 1444 revolutions per minute. Now with this data in mind, let's build a concept here from the torque speed diagram. So this is the torque speed diagram, and here if you plug in these two values, you can see that the maximum occurs at 229. So this is 229, and the speed at which it occurs is 1447. So this is the concept. You can easily get the idea from the graph for induced torque and the speed. Okay, the next is, what is the starting torque of this motor? Now, these were the formulas that we had studied. This is for the induced torque, this is S maximum, this is maximum torque. And now the starting torque, what is the concept here? Look here, this is the stator field rotating at synchronous speed. The rotor is not rotating, it's fixed, it is not moving. And therefore, there will be maximum slip between the two. This is static and this is moving. And so the slip at the start will be 100%. And that means S is equal to 1. So we'll plug in the value of S is equal to 1 and this to get the starting torque equation. So the starting torque, we plug in the value of S is equal to 1 and this. So this is the equation, and here now again plug in all the values. So the starting torque will be 104 Newton meters. Again we go back to the graph to see what is this concept. Now see the torque speed curve, it is starting at this point, which is 104. So the starting torque we have calculated to be 104 Newton meters. When the speed is zero, that means the rotor is not moving, it is here. Okay, coming on to third part, we have to calculate the speed and the starting torque when the resistance is doubled. So let's double the resistance. Earlier it was 0.332, now we have doubled it to 0.664. So we have to find the speed. We'll use this formula. We don't know what is the slip. Now we can use this formula to calculate slip by putting R2 is equal to 0.664. Now instead of doing that, we can see that the relation between slip and the R2 is direct. So if the R2 has doubled, that means the slip would be doubled also. We calculated the slip to be 0.19, so we double it to get 0.396. We could have calculated it also, no problem. Okay, so using that slip, now we can calculate the maximum torque speed, putting in this formula. So this is the mechanical speed when the resistance is doubled. Now you can see what is happening, that when the speed has increased, when the resistance or the load on the motor has increased, the resistance or the speed has reduced. It was 1.4 something earlier and now it has become 1.087. And this phenomena you can see from this graph also. This is for the double load, and now you can see that at maximum torque the speed is 1.087. And now what is the starting torque? This was the formula for starting torque. So plugging in the values, we get 170. And from this graph for the double R2, you can see that the starting torque is 170 when the speed is zero. And finally, the question asks us to plot this graph which we have been using. So you can take help of MATLAB to plot this graph. The program is given in the book, so you can try that and see if you can get this graph. So I hope this gives you an understanding how you can solve this question. Thank you.